to how to make a website for free. However, with Pro Free Host, you can get it for free. We need to create an account first. To do that, I will click on Register Now. All you need is an email address for registration and a password. So I'll quickly type in an email address and password and click on Tick. And I've successfully created my account, but I will have to activate it first. To do that, I will log in to my email first and click on the email by Pro Free Host. Now I will click on Activate Account. Now, as you can see, my account has been activated. Now that we have an account, we can move ahead with the next step, domain registration. To choose a domain name, we need to click on Create New Account. Now, we need to choose a domain name. I will try something random as it's just a tutorial video. Let's say Cafe Books. And the domain name is available. Now, we have an option to change our domain name's extension. We have two options. Zyro.com and Unox. However, I will go with Unox. And now let's scroll down and click on the tick button over here to claim our domain name. I just need to add WP admin to my site's name and press enter. Now I need to copy the username and password that I saved earlier on my Sticky Notes app and click on login. And now I am redirected to the WordPress dashboard. This is the place where we can modify our site. I will go to Appearances and click on Themes. And now let's click on Add New. And let's search for the theme Astra. This is the theme that I'm looking for. I will now click on Install. Our theme has now been installed. I'll click on Activate. As you can see, Astra has been installed. Let's click on Get Started. And now we need to select a website builder from here. So I will choose Elementor as my preferred site builder. Over here we have several designs that we can use for our site. We can also filter out the design categories by clicking on the drop-down box over here. I will click on blog. As you can see, we have filtered out all the blog templates. However, I like this one, fashion lifestyle blog. This template has the home page, the blog page, and the contact page. I like this template. I'll click on import complete site to import it and click on import. We can skip this option and our site is getting imported. Let's now click on View Site. As you can see, this is the template that we just imported. I'll scroll down and see the new look of my site. Let's have a look at other pages as well. I will click on Blog. Let's also view the contact page. Content of any page, we just need to click on the Edit with Elementor option present on the top over here. Let's say I wish to edit my home page. To do that, I will go to Home Page and click on the Edit with Elementor option. And that brings us to Elementor's editing section. Elementor allows one-click editing option to the users. Let's check it out. Suppose I wish to change the title here. All I need to do is select the text and write my own version of the text. Let's say free website. Similarly, we can also change the other features of our title, such as the color or the alignment of the text. For starters, I will show you how to change the color of this text. I will hover over to style and choose the text color option. Next, we will click on the text color and select a suitable color for our title. I will go with this one. Next, I will show you how we can edit this button. I will change it from Read More to Free Tutorial. And it's done. Let's scroll a bit. Next, I wish to change the image over here. Let's click on this image and hover over this option and select Choose Image. Now I'll select files from my computer. This is the image that I wish to choose. Let's now click on Insert Media. As you can see, the image has been updated. Now I'll click on the Update button over here. The changes have been updated. Let's click on Preview Changes to view our site. This is how our site looks now. Let's start with the header section first. To do that, I will click on Customize. Now we can edit the header by clicking on the pencil icon. Let's click on it and click on Change Logo. We can now change the logo of our website by choosing an image from our computer. Let's click on Select Files. This is the logo that I wish to use for my website. Next, I'll click on Select. Next, we can rescale the logo as per our needs. Once we are done rescaling, we can click on Crop Image. And we have the new logo over here. Similarly, you can edit other header sections by just a click. I will now adjust the logo width to optimize the look of my site. To save the changes, I will click on the Publish button over here. Now let's click on the cross button to verify the changes on our site. As you can see, the changes have been reflected on our site. Moving on, let's see how to edit the footer section of our site. For that, I will click on Customize and then I'll scroll down. This is the footer section of our site. To edit it, I'll simply click on Footer and then on Footer Bar. Now I wish to change the Section 1 custom text. To do that, I'll simply delete the text and change it to Copyright Ad Free Website text. To do that, I'll simply delete the text and change it to Copyright Ad Free Website. And the changes have been updated on our site. Next, to remove other footer elements, I'll click on Section 2 and change it to None. And lastly, I wish to move the Copyright Free Website option to the center. To do that, I'll simply click on this option over here. Now, to save the changes, I'll click on the Publish button on the top. I'll click on the cross button to go back to our site. As you can see, the changes have been reflected on our site. To do that, I'll hover over to New and click on Page. Next, we need to add a page title for our site. Let's say Free Website Design. I will design the rest of the page with the help of Elementor. So let's click on Edit with Elementor. Designing from scratch with Elementor. On the left side of this page, you can see the various elements available in Elementor. The best part about these elements is that you can just drag and drop them to your page. Let me show you how. Suppose I wish to add a heading text. I can do so by dragging the heading text element from here and dropping it over here. I can also change the text. And change it to Free Website Templates. Let's say that I wish to change the color of the heading. To do that, I will click on Style and hover over to Text Color and click on this box and choose a suitable color for the heading. And this color looks just fine. Next, I wish to add an image. To do that, I'll simply click on this plus icon over here and select a suitable structure for my page. I'll be selecting this structure for now. Next, I'll click on plus and drag and drop the image element from the left menu bar. Now I'll click on Choose Image and choose a suitable image from my computer. I'll click on Select Files. This is the image that I wish to use. Next, I'll click on Insert Media. And here's our website template. Now, I wish to add a new button next to our image. To do that, I'll simply hover over and drag and drop a button element from the left. And it's that simple. So, now I would like to change the text of my button. To do that, I'll just click on it and simply type in click to download. Now if I wish to change the color of my button, I would simply hover over to style and click on the box next to the background color button. Now you can try various combinations and choose your favorite color. I will however go with black for now. Now I wish to change the alignment of this button. So I'll simply hover over to the button and click on the layout icon. And then on the vertical align, I'll set the default to middle. So this is how you change the alignment of your button. So now we can directly go over to installing WordPress. Let's click on manage. And on control panel. Now we have a disclaimer message asking for my permission to enable email notifications. I will click on I approve. And we are at Pro Free Hosts control panel. Let's scroll down and click on the Softaculous Apps installer. Let's hover over WordPress and click on install. Now we can scroll down and fill in the admin username. I will copy them on my sticky notes app for now. And after scrolling down, I will click on install. This setup takes a couple of minutes. And WordPress has been successfully installed. We have a link to our website. Let's click on it. As you can see, our website is now live. However, it doesn't look good. It may seem too basic or may not even look like a website to you now, which is using a ready-made template. To do that, simply click on the starter templates icon over here. And as you can see, there are many templates for us to choose from. Let's select it. This is how the template looks. So now I'll click on Import Template to import it to my site. As you can see, this is how the design template looks on our site. Not bad, right? But however, you might have noticed that the default text of our website has been imported along with the template. For instance, if I wish to change this text, I'll simply click on it and change it to Free Website Templates. Let's scroll down. And let's say if you wish to remove an entire section, then we'll simply click on the cross icon on the top. And to update the changes, I'll simply click on the update button over here. You can view the page by clicking on preview changes. So this is how our free website templates page looks like.